We are an old established market. This is well over 150 years old, this market. People who, let's say, have a good business, Tony on the vegetables, myself, the fruit stalls, and then you get the other stalls, like over there, which are very good and everything, but also you get smaller stalls, which are sort of, there's a saying, they're living off our scraps. Without us, they wouldn't get a living, but they make the market like everybody.
Describe this market in one word.
Fascinating.
Eclectic.
Not very busy sometimes.
Useful.
Wonderful.
Amazing.
Good.
Vibrant.
Marvellous.
In that time, there was three fish stalls. I'm now the only one. There was, in probably the region of maybe 25 to 30 fruit, veg and salad stalls, plus egg stall, two different egg stalls I can remember, a chicken stall I can remember. So then that's what made it a food market.
What changes have you seen in Chapel Market over the years?
It's very quiet at the moment, but let's be fair, there's a lot of things going on in the world, monetary and other things, and everybody is affected by it at the moment.
A lot quieter, I think, probably since the stalls and the M1 centre's been opened. Yeah, they took a lot away from the street traders, so basically they're mainly regulars. We don't really get a lot of trade from the market people. It's mainly regulars, you know, because it's cheap. Regulars and lunatics.
Come and get your leather jackets here, real leather. They're £50 for one, two for 18, three for 110. Real leather, row! Leo's Boutique, the only boutique selling real leather and suede.
I think it's like the last sort of old school East End hub of society left. And it's one of it's the oldest market in Islington. And it's basically a nice place to meet people and friends and family and people from school, people in the neighbourhood.
Anyone can do a business if they basically open up the doors to them and have less red tape. More people will be employed and pitch up in markets as casuals, and then there'll be more of a society, more back to the old school, instead of moving on and there being no society and no one saying hello to each other in the street, neighbours not knowing each other, no cultures understanding each other's cultures. And I think that's what's wrong with the way the media is just completely taking over the world.
Hurry back, hurry home to my arms.